Welcome, everybody. My name is Warwick Sabin. I'm the publisher of the Oxford American Magazine. It's a pleasure to be here in Oxford, Mississippi, and we'd like to thank Off Square Books and Square Books, Lisa and Richard Howorth, for having us here this afternoon. And thanks to all of you for being here. I'd like to begin, without any hesitation, to thank Governor Haley Barbour for being here with us today. It's truly an honor to have the governor of the state with us to help us with this monumental event for our magazine, launching our Mississippi Music issue. But I also want to take this opportunity, as Governor Barbour's term is coming to a close, to thank him as somebody who lives in Arkansas, but who publishes a magazine about the South that gets out around the nation and around the world, for your commitment to preserving Mississippi's heritage and culture and understanding its value, not only as an economic development tool and as a tool to bring tourists to the state of Mississippi, but in general, just to help Southerners value the culture they have. I think a lot of times we undervalue all of the good things that come from the South, whether it's the food, the music, the literature, and you clearly recognize that and have promoted that throughout your tenure as governor, and we admire that from our position.
We really do consider ourselves, with great reason, the birthplace of America's music. If you look behind me, on our country music trail is this marker for Jimmy Rogers from Meridian, Mississippi, the father of country music. I just came over from Tupelo, the home of Elvis Presley, the king of rock and roll. There's nobody with a straight face who doesn't recognize that the Mississippi Delta is the home of the blues, and this marker right here for the king of the blues. Born in Urbana, got a museum in Indianola, and hit most every other juke joint within I don't know how many miles, and God bless him, still going. So our Mississippi heritage is not only something we have a lot to be proud of, it is, as was mentioned, part of our economy. Malcolm and I agree, it's not a big enough part of our economy. It should be more of our economy, and it is becoming more and more of our economy, and we appreciate the fact that we get supported, Warwick, by organizations like yours. Let me just close by saying this. I'm leaving as governor in about a month. One of the things I will look back to with pride is what we have done in Mississippi in these 8 years to promote our music. The Grammys show, we're the only state in the United States that the Grammys organization allows to have a show every year honoring our Grammy nominees and winners. It's because we've had more Grammy nominees and winners per capita than any other state in the United States. And God bless the Grammys organization for recognizing it. This great literary town, Mayor, that we have is a jewel known from one end of the world to the other that we benefit from. I mean, Richard, how many people could own three bookstores in one town, even with this many college students? I know a lot of those college students. They hadn't been in a bookstore in a lot of them. This is a great little literary town surrounded by the state that really is the birthplace of America's music. A town of writers and a state of artists and something for which we can all be proud and of which we all are proud. So thank you all for being part of this. Mary Beth's we're gonna all come up here and try not to mess this up.
Okay, where do you want me? Over here?
All right. Throw it over and let it fall to the ground.
Perfect.
Voila.
Come on, baby, let's go.
Chibata.